In this video, we will talk about satisfaction surveys and feedback forms. Organizations need satisfaction surveys from their volunteers because satisfaction is interdependent with productivity. More satisfied volunteers are happier for their work, more committed, and more productive. You should keep in mind that an unsatisfied volunteer will leave. Also, an unsatisfied volunteer has a bad attitude which affects the team, the reputation, and the reliability of the organization. We will see some general instructions for preparing a satisfaction survey. First of all, the survey should be anonymous. You should ask direct questions. The survey should be small, maximum 20 questions, and regular, every 15 days or 1 month, according to the type of the work. Finally, you should separate the questions per category, for example, work environment, relationship with the managers, etc. In addition, you should think about which things you need to learn from your satisfaction survey, for example, interpersonal relationship, work recognition, training opportunities, importance of the work, good work environment, and other. Some questions you can ask in your survey can be general. For example, how happy are you at work? How motivated are you to see the organization accomplishing its goals? Do you find your work meaningful? Also, some questions you can ask about interpersonal relationships are: do you feel connected to the other volunteers in the organization? Do you get the help you need from more experienced members? Do the people in the organization value your feedback? Do you feel valued, rewarded for your contribution? Do you have the opportunity to develop new ideas? Other types of questions focus on the work. For example, do you have the tools and technologies you need to fulfill your job? Are your job responsibilities clearly defined from the beginning of your work? Do you believe there is a good use of your skills and abilities? Do you believe there are enough training opportunities? Do you believe that this job updates your skills? There are different types of answers your survey can have. The first category is scale. Scale 1, from 1 to 10. From 1 to 10, how happy are you at work? Scale 2, strongly disagree, disagree, neither agree or disagree, agree, strongly agree. Other types of answers your survey can have are: small paragraph, for example, suggestions for the improvement of the work, or which of the following best describes? You give 5 options with the last one to be other. Feedback forms. They can be used for almost everything, from really formal occasions to informal ones. They are absolutely necessary and mutually desirable, and their absence may threaten the effectiveness and the orientation of the team. The characteristics of feedback are: the source, the content of the message. What is the sign of it? Is it positive or negative? The context within which the feedback is made, under what circumstances and for what purpose and at what point in time is it decided to give the message with this sign? Reaction of the recipient. Finally, there are some criteria of an effective feedback. It should be given both in regular and occasional, formal or informal. It is a special technique that needs preparation. You have to design it according to the specific outcome you expect from the intervention. The feedback message, whether positive or negative, should relate to specific aspects of the volunteer's performance so far and be linked to specific goals that are to be met so that the change is correlated with future results. Last but not least, the person who gives the feedback should be considered trustworthy. Focus on the subject. Feedback is not a monologue, but a structured form of interaction that takes time. Thank you for your attention.